Am I Good Enough? Part 3 of the Recruiting Framework. This is the Athletic Scholarship Podcast, episode number 176. Welcome to the longest-running podcast on athletic scholarships and recruiting. Jon Fugler, your host. I'm an athletic scholarship coach and a dad of two scholarship athletes. I'm also the CEO of Recruit Me, a podcaster, author, and speaker. And so good to have you on board as we get set for Christmas. And we're going to have fresh episodes, by the way, all the way through the end of the year. No replays. Nada. We're going to get some fresh stuff here. We're on a hot topic about the recruiting framework right now. And this is part 3, as I mentioned. Hey, I thank you so much for your questions. I've gotten quite a few lately. And I'll tell you, this one is really the best one that I've received in a long time. And Emily, thank you for asking this. And Emily asked these two questions. First of all, she started and gave me a nice compliment. She said, I love your podcasts and book. I recommend them to all my friends. So thank you. And she listened to episode number 141, which is 7 people to interview during a campus visit, which I highly recommend you listen to because I know you're thinking about visits. Maybe you got some planned as you get into the new year. And 7 people to interview during a campus visit. So she asked this question. She asked, I'm wondering if you have a list of questions for each person on the list. Oh, that is... And I have to say, no, I don't, but I will. This is a podcast episode. I'm going to do a podcast episode right after the first of the year with a list of questions to ask each person that I tell you to interview on a campus visit. So, Emily, if you can wait, I'll get to that right after the first of the year, and I will probably add it to the upcoming revised edition of the Athletic Scholarship Playbook. So be looking for that. Secondly, she said, and... she says, I'm wondering if you have a list of commonly asked questions from the coach so I can help my son start thinking about organizing his thoughts and preparing his responses for the campus visit. And I had to say, no, I don't. So two no's. Emily, you got 2 strikes on me here. I'm glad you didn't ask 3 questions. But I'm going to do a podcast episode on that as well. These are excellent questions that I didn't have the answers for. I think this is the first time on the show I've said, nope, don't have the answer. Let's move on. But I will get the answer for you. And I will include that in early January podcast dedicated just to that, because that's critical. In my book and in past podcasts, I've shared what you want to ask a coach, but you got to be prepared for what the coach might ask you. So I love that. Thank you, Emily. And we'll get to those. And I'm going to add those to appendices in my next edition of the Athletic Scholarship Playbook. That's the way we start today. I gave you no answers so far. And, well, Merry Christmas. I'll tell you what you can get me for a gift. You can get me for a gift is, how about some reviews on Apple Podcast reviews. Emily, if you love this, go ahead and give me a review. Others who enjoy the podcast, even if you don't like it, give me a review and see if we can chalk up some of those. It'll get more earballs on the podcast if you do, because Apple will then elevate it and it'll be out there for other parents and athletes. We've been talking about the recruiting framework. And what is this? If you listen to my last 2 episodes, it's a picture frame, basically. And inside that frame is where you want to keep this thing, this piece of artwork called recruiting. Kind of like that. Or you can picture it like staying on the court, staying on the rink, staying within the boundaries of the football field, soccer field, field hockey field, whatever it is, stay within those boundaries. And it's a framework. And we got the boundaries here that I'm setting up for you. We got 4 boundaries that we're talking about and going into depth on each one of those. Last week, after the overview 2 weeks ago, last week, we talked about vision and goals. That's the top piece of the recruiting framework. You got to shoot high. And not only that, you've got to have solid goals, measurable, so you know whether you succeeded or not. You got something that is tangible to shoot for. Listen to the last episode, number 175, on vision and goals. Now we're going on to the second part. I'm going to go right down to the bottom of the frame, because if this isn't here, then your scholarship is just going to fall right through the bottom of the frame. You're going to go rolling off the field and down the hill, literally, if you don't have this in place. This is a foundation for you being able to get an athletic scholarship. You got to have talent. I mean, you can do all the things I tell you to do step by step. You can follow all the advice of any scholarship coach. You can hire somebody to do it all for you. But if you don't have this one thing, you will not get a scholarship. And that one thing is talent. Talent is the bottom piece of the recruiting framework. I started this show off and asked the question, am I good enough? And that's something that you've probably been asking as an athlete or as a parent. You're asking, well, is my son or daughter good enough to get a scholarship? You're existing in a world that you don't have any parameters, anything to compare their talent to when it comes to athletic scholarships. You might be kind of in a fog. And that's okay. That's where most of us are. That's where we were. We hope and we pray that our kid can get an athletic scholarship. And then we kind of doubt ourselves. We have this. We're confident sometimes. Other times we doubt. And we ask, is he good enough? Is she good enough? Is she good enough to get that scholarship? And I want to put that in perspective for you. You got to have perspective because it's not just a yes or no answer. You got to have perspective on this. We think about athletic scholarships. A lot of times we look at some of the top schools, top programs in the country, the ones that are on TV all the time, the ones that get all the publicity. And we think, wow, am I talented enough? Is my kid talented enough to compete at that level? And will they get a scholarship at Ohio State or USC or Notre Dame, some of those schools? Maybe they will. Maybe they will. But that isn't the whole ball game. You don't have to get a scholarship at the top school. You need to be, your son or daughter needs to be at the school which is the best fit. I keep saying that. It's so true. You want to be at the school that's the best fit. Be thinking about that even before the athletic piece, because there's so much more to an education. How about the education part? Yeah, the academics, college life. There's other things that contribute to that being the best fit. The style of coaching that the coach has, the chemistry on the team, the personality of the team, all these things contribute to what would be the best fit. And there's some other things too. So keep that in mind. So let's get to this talent piece. I just tell you from our experience with our kids, our twin sons who got an athletic scholarship each to compete at the school of their choice and the sport they love. They played baseball. They were not the best kids in the state. They were among the best in the county and on their team, but they weren't the best. They weren't the ones that were guaranteed an athletic scholarship where all the top schools in the country were seeking them out. They had to do what I explained that you need to do, and that is take the initiative. Go out there and seek those scholarships. Go out there and get in front of the right coaches. Go out there and get your information, your packet out in front of the right coaches. That's their situation. And they came away with great results, fully paid education, the school of their choice, and the sport they love. And they had some options open to them because they pursued. Now, we had some disappointments along the way. There were some programs that they really felt that they could compete on. And yet, we came to a dead end on a couple of those. They realized, the coaches made it clear that our boys didn't have the talent level to compete at that school. Or there just wasn't a spot for them in their position for the class they were going into. And that's the case too. The talent level might be fine, but there may be somebody else competing for that same position that is better, has better grades, and is similar talent level to you, but has better grades, better student. There's some variables in that. But I want to make it clear that if you, as an athlete or parent, if your son or daughter has the talent to compete at the next level, to compete in college, then I believe that he or she can get an athletic scholarship. And I've seen that happen over and over again. And one of the things that keeps athletes from getting an athletic scholarship is just you give up. You give up because it's tough. It's not easy. It's not easy to get that scholarship. You're competing with a lot of other athletes. But if you've got the talent to compete at the next level, you can get an athletic scholarship. So when you say, how talented? Am I talented enough? Am I good enough? Well, think about this. You've got Division I programs. You got Division II. You got Division III. And you say, well, they don't offer athletic scholarships. No, but they offer other types of scholarships. And you better believe that coaches are recruiting athletes and they're finding money for athletes that they want in their program. So these D3 schools are some of the best academic institutions in the country. You've got NAIA as well as NCAA, hundreds of schools that are options that are open at different levels. And I advise athletes that I work with, families that I work with, that when you're making your list of schools that you want to approach, that are on your prospect list, that you want three categories. You want a category that's a huge stretch for you. This is like your two or three dream schools. You're saying, man, if everything turns out all right, and man, I just improve a lot in the next year or two, that this could be a reality. Those are the ones that you shoot for that, man, that makes you excel. And you want two or three of those. And you want a handful of schools that, you know, you're going to get a scholarship there. You can get in. You got a great chance of getting some scholarship money there. And then those are kind of below what you're shooting for academic and athletically probably. And then the third area is the bulk of these schools in your prospect list. Those are the ones that are the best fit for you. And they're a challenge, and yet it's realistic that you can get in at those schools and you could get some scholarship money. So you need to really look at it. You need to look at the variety of programs out there, the variety of schools out there, the talent level that they're recruiting. How does it match up with your son or daughter's talent level? Be realistic. Get some evaluations of your son or daughter's talent level. We had the real privilege of having a D1 coach in town. In fact, two of them were really honest with our kids to let them know where they felt they could fit in. And one of the things, it wasn't at that school. It wasn't at that D1 institution. And that was kind of hard to hear. However, their evaluation was realistic. And that led us to pursue schools that were within their talent range. And it helped us narrow things down, which you want. You want somebody to speak honestly to you. Get an honest opinion, whether it be from a college coach or somebody who has done this before in evaluating athletes, who can give you an accurate picture of where your son or daughter could fit in, what they should shoot for. Another place where you can get an honest evaluation is camps that your son or daughter attends. If it's a recruiting camp, that's great. If it's just a learning camp, that's fine too. But use this as an opportunity to ask the coach to be honest with you. Tell her that we want an honest opinion. We don't want you to just tell us what we want to hear. Let us know what level, what's my son or daughter's talent level here, and what should he or she be shooting for? That will really help you. It may be their school, it may not be their school, but the end result is you want the one with the best fit. That's so important. So are you good enough? If you can compete at the next level, I believe you are, and I've seen it over and over again. You just got to have your mind open to options that are out there that you may not know about right now. You want the best fit for your son or daughter. Athlete, you want the best fit because you want four great years where you're competing in your sport. I got something to share with you. I just put out an email last week about the best episodes of 2019 of the Athletic Scholarship Podcast. If you got that, go ahead and click on some of those. Listen to them. These are the best of 2019. I'll shoot another email out to you as well to alert you to that. Now, maybe I'll get it on my website as well, just so you can listen to those. Good stuff as you equip yourself for next year. And the next thing too, one last thing I want to remind you about is coming out in January is a project that has been in my heart and in my mind for over a year now, maybe 2 years. It's the Recruit Me Athletic Scholarship Planner. As you're getting ready to really embark on something special in 2020, I want to have the planner ready for you in January. All right, so it's just about completed, ready to go to press real soon here. It'll be out in January. And this is one place that you can work from to walk through your scholarship recruiting process, where you can plan, where you can journal, where you can keep important information, documents, things like that. You can build documents. It's a good record-keeping system, and that's coming out just after the first of the year. So hope you'll be able to use that and get that. It'll be available on Amazon. Now, we've covered two pieces of the recruiting framework today: talent, and you can see why that's the bottom piece, because it's got to be, you got to have talent or else everything's going to fall through the bottom, roll down the hill, off the sideline. Top one is vision and goals. Next week, we're going to be talking about the third element, the third piece of the recruiting framework. So listen in, and then we'll close the year with that fourth piece, and there you'll have it to head into 2020 of a complete framework for recruiting and scholarships in your pursuit. If you have any questions for me, please make them easy. Any questions, fine. John at recruitme.com. Your question might become a podcast episode, or I could maybe be able to answer it real quickly for you. But email me at john at recruitme.com. John at recruitme.com. Athlete, continue to work on your talent. Continue to get better. Do what you can to bring yourself up to the next level, that you can compete at the next level when you're done with high school. So keep it up. Go after it. Set goals for your talent. Pursue those goals. Get better. You can be better next month than you are today. You'll be better next year than you are today, and you'll be a better prospect as a result, but you got to work at it. God bless you. Take care, and we'll talk to you next week.